What's going on, people? Your boy Joe Pags. If you don't know who I am, I'm a radio talk show host, also appear on television a lot, nationally syndicated, 130-plus stations, 4.5 million listeners. I talk about social media all the time. I'm still suspended by Twitter, and what I've noticed in the past 10, 11 days, whatever it's been, it'll be 2 weeks on Tuesday, so it'll be 11 days Sunday, and I'm actually doing it at like 1:49 a.m., so it is Sunday. I'm still locked out. The reason why I was suspended is I put in hashtag hydroxychloroquine works. That's all I said. Not take it. Not ignore your doctor. Not, you know, drink some fish tank cleaner like some couple allegedly did in Arizona. No, what I said is hashtag hydroxychloroquine worked. This was on the heels of my interview with Dr. Jerome Corsi, who's got a free ebook at CorsiNation.com, where he's got scientists, epidemiologists, doctors all agreeing that as a prophylactic, it is certainly effective, hydroxychloroquine, for coronavirus, but hydroxychloroquine works for malaria, works for lupus. In conjunction with zinc, it allegedly works for coronavirus, COVID-19, the China virus, whatever. And look, I get that many people will say, yeah, but you know, Twitter is its own website. They can make their own rules, do whatever they want. They really can't. They're acting like a publisher here and not like a platform. And they have this immunity from liability because they say they're an unbiased platform. This is clearly biased. Now, in the note I got that said, here's why you're suspended, it said that I didn't follow the WHO guidelines. I guess the WHO says you can't say hydroxychloroquine works. Well, study after study, including the latest one from an epidemiologist over at Yale, says, in fact, hydroxychloroquine works. So either we can say the truth and put out that an FDA-approved medicine that's been out there since, I don't know, the 1960s, and it has proven effective and has minimal side effects. Listen, if you've got some sort of a heart condition, certainly you're going to want to talk to your doctor more about it. But at the end of the day, this is an effective treatment, according to many studies, according to many doctors. And yes, doctors are prescribing it for many things, not just coronavirus, for malaria, for lupus at all. But here's really the crux of the issue. I'm finding during my suspension, I've only got about 100,000 people on there. In fact, I sneaked around and took a look, and I've lost about 300 or 400 followers on Twitter just because. It's not like somebody saying, wow, he's not tweeting, I'm going to delete him. No, Twitter's doing that. And I did appeal the suspension, and Twitter has ignored my appeal. They say they'll take a look at it and get back to me. But the bottom line is this. There are many big names there on Twitter, millions upon millions upon millions of followers, including many of them who are conservative. Many of them who agree with me on hydroxychloroquine and on many issues, who aren't saying a peep about my suspension. And I'm getting the feeling that they're afraid to. Listen, some big names like Ted Cruz certainly have taken up for me. I believe Dan Bongino did. I know that Tracy Beans has. There are plenty of people who have taken up for me. But think about this. If every conservative voice that had hundreds of thousands, if not millions of followers, hit Twitter and said, hey, unsuspend or take off the suspension on Joe Talk Show, I think maybe Twitter would listen. Twitter doesn't think it has to listen because there's really no blowback over this dumb suspension. Again, if I'm you know, committing some crime or telling people to be violent, which is what Antifa and Black Lives Matter and other organizations do all the time on Twitter, maybe now I get where you're coming from. But when you're censoring the president of the United States and when you're censoring a talk show host who just says the truth, now you've got an issue on your hands. But there has to be a lot of blowback. Yes, I'm on Parler, Parler.com. My name there is Joe Pags, Joepags. It's an up-and-coming website that I believe in, but it's only got about 3 or 4 million followers there or subscribers there now. Twitter's got over 300 million, and Twitter can't have this kind of power to shut down any sort of diverse voice. I thought the left wanted diversity. I am diverse from what normally you would see on Twitter. So do me a favor. You see the address here, at Joe Talk Show. That's me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Go to Twitter and put me right there in the message that you're going to send, in the tweet you're going to send, and urge other big accounts on Twitter to repeat what you said, retweet it, or like it, or comment on it. And I mean, get the at that has the biggest number of followers that you follow. And make sure you tweet to that person, hey, Joe Pags has been off of Twitter for a week and a half, almost 2 weeks now. It's time for us to get behind making Twitter stop this suspension of people who are telling the truth. I said nothing egregious, nothing beyond that. And do me a favor, share this video on Twitter. Make the Twitter bosses see that you're not going to stand still for this, that a guy who said the truth and a guy who has a pretty good following on Twitter, but a huge following nationally, doesn't deserve this treatment. And the website needs to give in, see my protest or my appeal, and then unlock my account. It's really that simple. I'm going to put this on YouTube. I'm going to put this on Parler. I'm going to put this on Facebook. And again, go to Twitter specifically. Follow me at Joe Talk Show. So build the following as they're suspending me. That would really bother them. And also, make sure that you send a message, a tweet, and put the at sign, and then whoever your biggest person is that you follow, make sure he or she knows that this egregious thing is happening. Others have been suspended for saying similar things. They have deleted the tweet, and they got back on. I'm not going to delete the tweet. That's not how this works. They should be accountable when they take somebody down for telling the truth. All right, I'm going to go now. Do me a favor. Like and subscribe if you're watching this on YouTube. Like and subscribe. Hit the bell. And go to Twitter specifically and make sure that you share this video everywhere. And again, make sure you include in that tweet the at sign that has the largest following, or the bunch of them that have a large following, to make sure they're A, aware of it, and B, they're unafraid to go up against Twitter and say, hey, this isn't okay. Enough is enough. All right, I appreciate you. Talk soon.